trying to figure out love. That is rough. Love. That is very difficult. It's a lot to it. I don't know. I'm not good at it at all, frankly. I'm trying to get better at it. I think I'm getting better at it, but it's just, you don't have, I like the wrong people. And I'm not about to say that, you know, I have bad luck or I'm, you know, oh my God, what, look at me with 10 shitty people in a row. I don't know what's wrong. It's me. I pick bad, I like bad boys. I like bad boys. I don't mean like a motorcycle and an earring. That's a homosexual. I mean, like, a fucking asshole. Like, you have two options as a lady. You know, I actually like to say, I like to say that if I want to fuck you, that's not a compliment. It's a diagnosis. There's something very wrong with you. And if you don't already know that, then fucking thank me for telling you that by fucking you. But you have two options as a lady. You have a guy over here who's like, you know, I love you, you're beautiful, you're amazing, you're perfect, I want to give you money and cupcakes and prizes and shit, right? Then you have a guy over here who's like, I don't like you, go away, you're the worst, boo to you. And then every time I just weigh the two, I'm like, all right, this guy has prizes. This guy does not like me. All right, that's good things to think about. Weigh the two, balance it out, figure it out. It's a hard one, you know. And every time you start it, like, I try to fix a shitty guy every single time, and it never fucking works. It's never worked. It's never paid off, right? I met a guy recently who I thought was like, this is for me. This is the right choice for me. He was like, I always say, like, I want a guy who is, you know, he gets it, but he can fix shit, you know? And my friends would always be like, there's no funny lumberjacks. That's a weird request. But I met a guy who was amazing, like incredible, and he was funny and lovely, and he like lived in Vermont in the woods, you know? Like in a house in the woods, not in the actual woods, like a weird creature. But he was like incredible, and he would like send me pictures of himself building his deck. He's like, look, I built a deck, you know, and I'd write back like, oh, I took a taxi two blocks, we're different, you know. But I went out there. I went out there to visit him. I went to Vermont. I sledded. I'm from LA. I sledded for this guy, right? I went to the Goodwill. I bought a head-to-toe red snowsuit. I went careening down the hill. He was like, oh, look, it's the Red Baron. And I said, are you making fun of me because I can't have children? And what? That was fun. That was fun that that happened. And then I go to New York, and he was like, I want to come see you. And I gave him permission, because he's a grown man, and he needs that. Gave him permission to come see me. He was so happy. He was so happy I gave him permission to come see me. He wrote back, I can't stop smiling, XOXO. Yeah, a guy who built a deck couldn't stop smiling, XOXO. I don't know if it's because I'm a comedian, because I moved around a lot as a kid, and I'm just a cynical person, but it took all of the willpower in my entire being to not write back, like, fag. You fucking faggot. Maybe that's why I'm single, right? Maybe that's why I can't find... I can't find anybody, because the minute someone says, I love you, my first thought is like, oh, you love me. I want to go suck a dick if you love me so much. No, Morgan, I think you're beautiful. Oh, is this as beautiful as a fucking dick in your mouth? You're beautiful. That's how mature I get. I'm pretty mature. I just want to do 10 of those.
One more.
I just want to take care of you forever. Why don't you just take care of those fucking balls on your face? Let's do it.